my dear friends, we have been considerably delayed by fate. I call it fate. And I'm so glad we had a wonderful tribute to Joan Graham, to Christopher Sacco, and together with Patricia Terry Gross. And I'm so grateful to Zelda for coming and giving the introduction, or what should have been the introduction, but came at the right time for Christopher. Now we go to our next award winner. Our next award winner is Shuheng, one of the finest pianists of his age in Michigan, if not in the United States, maybe eventually you'll say of the world. The winner of numerous state, national, and international competitions, he was the only United States pianist invited by the Lang Lang International Music Foundation to attend the Alliance Junior Music Camp in 2016. This led to an invitation to Warsaw, Poland for a week of music, including a masterclass with Lang Lang himself, one of the most famous pianists in the world. Additionally, Shuheng has been selected as a festival participant in the 2017 Gina Bachauer International Piano Festival, to be held in Salt Lake City, Utah, in June. There are so many things one could say, but I think we should stop here and say that we are honored and very pleased to present Shuheng Zhang, and his first piece will be 32 Variations in C Minor, WOO80, by Ludwig van Beethoven. Thank you.
Thank you.
I think you know what you have heard. Yeah. And I want to tell you that when you, this boy here is part of the student league that Velda Kelly is the advisor of. And this is the quality that we get from this wonderful group of people. But Shuheng is an extraordinary young man, and I think he will soar into the heights of great musical. And we wish you that, Shuheng. We wish you that for your sake and for the listeners who will be nourished by your wonderful playing. And for all of you, I want you to know that when you join us as members of Tuesday Musicale, when you donate what you can, as you can, you are helping us to help these great and wonderful musicians make their way into the future, because we recognize them and we want to present them and we want to encourage them to continue in their work. So I ask you please to make this a reason for your connection and become brothers and sisters in the love of music. Now, we have with us today the man who is going to recognize and give to Shuheng, the Doreen Wessel Taylor Prize. We are honored to have Robert, why don't you stand? This wonderful gentleman is going to give to Mr. Shuheng Zhang his prize. He will introduce himself. That's why I'm keeping his name a secret. He will tell you his own name. And he will tell you who he is, who his wife is, and above all, who and why he is giving this prize, the Doreen Wessel Taylor Prize. Robert Taylor, the son of Doreen Wessel Taylor, will speak to you himself, and I will give him that opportunity. Thank you.
Good morning. All right, I guess I should say good afternoon. Sorry. Today is a special day for two reasons. First, the obvious, the chance to hear two talented, gifted young musicians. But the second reason that today is a special day is that it's my parents' wedding anniversary. Were my parents still alive, today would have been their 71st wedding anniversary. As it was, Mom and Dad had been married for 50 years. Dino Winters asked me to give you a bio of Fran, me, and Doreen. In the same breath, Dino said to keep it short. And since we are running into the lunch hour, I will keep it short. My wife over there is a retired school teacher, having retired after a 33-year career teaching grades 1 through 6. Fran taught for a few years on the East Coast. She taught for a few years in the Detroit public school system and taught most of the system. I'm an attorney and a CPA, and similar to your president, I'm still in the workforce. Now a little bit about Doreen. Doreen was born in Chile in 1921, but grew up in Copenhagen, Denmark. Her dad spoke Spanish, so Doreen learned to speak Spanish. Her mom spoke English, so Doreen learned to speak English. Mom's nanny spoke Danish, so Doreen learned to speak Danish. She was educated at the French school in Copenhagen, so Doreen learned to speak French. Denmark sits on top of Germany, and like every good Dane, Doreen learned to speak German. Which coincidentally, the entire Danish population forgot when Germany invaded Denmark. Doreen's dad was the Chilean ambassador to Denmark for most of his adult life, and his daughter's language skills helped him at many diplomatic social events, asking Doreen to attend those events as soon as he felt Doreen was old enough. Similar to our talented award recipient, Shuheng Zhang, Doreen, encouraged by one of her aunts, started learning to play the piano when she was 9 years old. That would have been in 1930. Doreen's parents had wanted her to receive advanced musical training in Germany, but Doreen's parents were forced to give up on that plan when Hitler invaded Austria in 1939.
Speaking to the mic.
Doreen was 18 years old. Doreen continued her musical studies during the war. Doreen continued her musical studies after marrying her father, after coming to Michigan, and while raising five children, all of whom, most likely to Doreen's dismay, were somewhat musically tone deaf. Despite the lack of musical talent amongst her own children, some of Doreen's grandchildren had inherited her musical gene. One of them was my son, Jamie. He played the trumpet, and when he was 15, he was good enough to be asked to participate in a local competition. But the competition wasn't for a solo performance. The competition was for a duo performance. Jamie didn't have to look far for a partner. Yep, he called up his grandma. To say that Doreen was overjoyed to be asked was an understatement. She was thrilled. The day of the competition, Doreen played perfectly. Not in terms of hitting the correct notes and having perfect timing, which goes without saying, but in terms of what you just saw, what you just witnessed with Patricia Terry Ross and Christopher Sacco. Like Patricia, Doreen made it clear to the judges who the star of that duo was, the trumpeter, not the piano player. Jamie received high scores, although not high enough to win the competition, but he did receive a backhanded compliment, which he passed on to Fran and myself, when one of the judges casually, nonchalantly, feigning a lack of interest, asked him, "Where did you find that lady who played the piano with you?" I believe it is this experience with Doreen's grandson, combined with her own experience growing up with music, that developed in Doreen a desire to encourage young people to develop their own musical talents. I cannot think of a more fitting way to celebrate Mom and Dad's wedding anniversary than handing out the Doreen Wessel Taylor Piano Award.
Thank you.